Thanks for joining me. Along with all Australians, I was shocked by the terrible scenes at former President Trump's campaign event in Pennsylvania. I'm relieved by the news that the former president is safe and doing fine, and I wish him and his family well. I applaud the swift work of US security agencies. I'm also saddened by reports that a member of the audience has lost their life and other attendees have been injured, and I send my condolences on behalf of Australia to their loved ones in this time of grief. Let us be clear. The people at this event, the candidate, the crowd, the free press covering it, were all participating in the democratic process. In Australia, as in the United States, the essence and the purpose of our democracies is that we can express our views, debate our disagreements, and resolve our differences peacefully. We do so with respect for each other and in the spirit of a shared love of our country. Any act of violence is an affront to that and must be condemned unequivocally. This was an inexcusable attack on the democratic values that Australians and Americans share and the freedom that we treasure. These values are ones that unite our two countries. It's the basis of our alliance, is those shared values between our peoples as great democratic nations. And all Australians stand with our friends in the United States at this difficult time. Happy to take a couple of questions.
Hang on. You've spoken recently about the increased political vandalism and whether that would increase to violence. Do the actions of today increase your concern, and will there be any changes to security here?
Well, the security agencies will examine these events. There's a great deal of cooperation as Five Eyes partners between Australia and the United States, and I'm sure that there will be lessons to be learnt. I say again, though, we must lower temperature of debate. There is nothing to be served by some of the escalation of rhetoric that we see in some of our political debate, political discourse in the democratic world. It's a phenomenon that's not unique to the United States. And I just say we should be able to have political discussion and disagreement, do it respectfully, and that is really important.